are responsible for the future that we want. And this reminds me of a story. There used to be a woman in some village. She was quite respected. She was wise, considered to be very wise. People went to her for all manner of reasons to find solutions. And one time, some three very cheeky young boys, I don't know whether there was a young girl, but I'm told they were young boys, said, look, this woman is not as bright or as wise as we imagine. And you're going to show the villagers that truly she's not as wise. And so they say, look, we're going to get a bird, and we're going to hold the bird in our hands, and we'll go to her and ask her, what are we holding in our hand? And there are chances that she will get it right, very high chances. And she will, if she says it's a bird, we'll ask her a follow-up question. Is the bird alive or is the bird dead? And if she says the bird is alive, we will squeeze it and kill it and show the villagers that, look, she said the bird is alive. Look, the bird is dead. If she says the bird is dead, we are going to release it for the villagers to see that she's not that wise. So they went to this woman and they asked her, madam, and they also mobilized the villagers and they asked her, what are we holding? And of course the wise woman said, you are holding a bird. And so they quickly asked the follow-up question because they wanted to trap her. Is the bird alive or is the bird dead? And so the woman looked at them and looked at the villagers and she said, look, young men, the life of that bird is in your hands. You can decide to kill it or you can decide to let it go. And so the young boys were really embarrassed because they wanted to trap her and they didn't make it. And so today I want to remind us that the future of this country is in our hands. We can decide to destroy it or we can decide to make it prosper.